I was planning to show two demonstrations, two demos. One was mainly based on the EPA capabilities. I mean, we are going to deploy a network service consisting of two VNFs that are using the EPA capabilities of OSM, and that means that it's possible to describe the resources in terms of memory of few pages, CPU pinning, pass-through interfaces, NUM awareness, things like that. And well, and I will illustrate that sending traffic from one to the other and seeing that, well, it's something real, that it's able to switch lots of millions of packets per second, okay? That's the main intention. The other demo was about day zero, day one and day two configuration, but it's not working. So I will focus on describing how the descriptors, let's say how the descriptors contain all the logic that is required for the different actions that will be driven. Okay, let's start with the demo of EPA. So, well, this is the dashboard that you know from the previous session. Let's see in the catalog the VNFs and network services that we have. So I'm planning to deploy a VNF that is this one here. It's a virtual VNG from Intel. Here it consists of a single VDU. It has 8 interfaces, you will see. Here, let me show you in the VM. Yeah, so you see them here, all of them, okay? You see lots of squares here. Each of them is an interface. So it consists of 8 pass-through interfaces, and also it has different guest EPA parameters. It has 32 gigs of RAM, and it requires, let's see the guest EPA parameters here below, just to show you that it contains a lot of information that is required in this case for the VNF to work. For instance, the use of large pages, the use of dedicated pinning, and the CPU thread pinning policy preferred. That means that we want always 2 threads of the same core to be provided, okay? So threads, hardware threads will be always provided in pairs. And also here it says NUM awareness. That means that all things, I mean all the interfaces, all the memory, and all the CPU will come from the same NUMA node in the compute node itself. Okay, so this is the VNF that we will deploy. In addition to that, in the network service, we will deploy, let me check here, a generator. Okay, this generator is, again, the same, 8 interfaces, and the idea is that the VNG is mainly, it's for testing purposes, but it's working as an actual VNG from the point of view of the data plane. It decapsulates the Q&Q, it's able to route the traffic, it's well, doing all the logic that is expected for a VNG, okay, for the residential access, okay? And it's also, it also contains all the logic for QoS shaping and policing, okay? And well, the idea is that this VNG will have 4 interfaces that go to the user side of the network, another 4 interfaces that go to the, let's say, one side of the network. All 4 and 4 will be connected to the traffic generator, and we will inject traffic in both directions. So let's see the network service. This is the network service. I will try to show it here. So you see here that it might be too complicated to see, but it's the 2 VNFs and 8 networks. So that means that each port of each one port of the generator is connected to one port of the VNG. Okay. Well, that's what we are going to deploy. Let's select the descriptor. 1 second. Here, instance it. This one, we are going to deploy it in this case, we are going to deploy it in an OpenVim. OpenVim is one of the VIMs that is provided by OSM. It's one of the, it contains, let's say, all the appropriate logic to deploy VNFs that requires have data plane characteristics. Okay, so in this case, an OpenVINE that is based on compute nodes with Skylake. Okay, that's why it's called Sky. And I think that all I need to select here is the management network. I want the management network to be MGMT. This instructs the VIM to connect the management interfaces to the management network so that they are reachable from OSM or from the, let's say, management network of the operation. Let's deploy. Oh, sorry, the name. I forgot. So OSM works. Launch. Well, it takes now some time to. Meanwhile, I can show you, for instance, in the catalog, I can show you the different guest TPA parameters in the descriptor, okay, so that you could see them again. And it's much clearer for you the meaning. Here, you can see it in the YAML viewer. This is the descriptor, okay, and you will see there the different connection points, the different interfaces, and for each VDU, the flavor information, okay. Memory, storage, the main page size, all the guest TPA parameters, the image it's based on, and the different interfaces. Okay, you could see here in the interfaces that we are specifying to use PCI pass-through. That means that we want the PCI, the interface to be pass-through from the compute host. So for this deployment to work properly, we are using, well, not exactly SDN assist. OpenVINE is a VIM that incorporates the capability to create the underlying connectivity between the let's say virtual machines that are using SRIOV or pass-through interface. So OpenVINE has that built-in capability, but some VIMs that do not have the capability to create the underlying connectivity, that means connecting pass-through interfaces from different VMs. For that, we have the SDN assist feature. So I think it's a good opportunity to show you how this SDN assist feature works, because this is, for instance, what we use in the context of when we deploy in OpenStack, and the OpenStack does not support this capability, okay, by default. So first thing is that VMs are deployed normally, okay? So whenever a new instance is created, the different VNFs and the virtual machines that compose that VM are deployed. And as a result of that deployment, the OSM is able to get the specific host and PCI address that is assigned to the VM. Okay? So this is obtained by OSM, particularly by the resource orchestrator. That's the model responsible of doing the deployments. Okay? And based on that information will be used to instruct later on an SDN controller. How? Because OSM will have a port mapping that, let's say, identify the mapping between the PCI address of the compute node and each specific port in the OpenFlow switch. So, for instance, in this case, the interface of PCI address PCI1 of compute node 0 is connected to port S1 in the switch. That information needs to be fed to OSM so that it's possible to later on, based on that mapping, instruct the SDN controller. That's the third and last step. It's the way OSM works, is that it talks to the SDN controller and tells the SDN controller to connect those ports. In this case, we want an E-line connectivity, for instance, and by E-line we mean that all traffic from one port should be passed to the other port and the other way around. Okay, the rules to be configured in the switch are pretty simple. Is whatever comes in port S1 should go out to port S7, and whatever comes from port S7 should go to port S1. Okay? Is it clear the way SDN works? It's not that complicated, okay? So this is what happened. Hopefully the instantiation will be finished. Well, yes, active, okay, it's working. So now let me show, I will inject some traffic to illustrate that it's real and it's work and it's able to, let's say, switch lots of packets per second. So I will get the IP address of each of the VNFs. In this case, this is the generator, this is the VNG itself. So for the generator, let's take the IP address here. Here. 203. And I will do SSH to that machine. 203. So this is the generator. I will have to run a few commands to make it ready, mainly this. I could have included in a cloud init, but I didn't do it. Sorry for that. So now it's just the Let me check the specific command because I always forget. It's here. Okay. This is to generate traffic, and I will execute as soon as we have connected it to the generator. Sorry, to the BNG. I will connect to the BNG. Here I will get the IP address. This is the IP address, 206. Okay, it's ready. So I'm starting right now the BNG. This is the process that starts the BNG, and we will see a cool terminal showing all the traffic, etc. Okay. This is the traffic. So here you see from 0 to 7 the different interfaces of the or different ports of the BNG. Those who have a name CPE 0 to CPE 3 are, let's say, pointing to the user side of the network, and those called INET 0, INET 1 to INET 3 are pointing to the one side of the network. Okay. So what's relevant is to see here the received packets per second, okay, and transmitted packets per second. And I will open right now the generator. The generator has a similar window, and let's switch to the. This is the BNG itself. Okay, so here you can see that we are getting 48 million packets per second. Okay, switched by the BNG itself. How good is this? Normally, figures are given in terms of gigabits per second or bits per second. You have to take into account that it's not a good measurement of the switching capability of any node, because what's relevant is how quick are you dealing with packets, okay? Because packet is the, let's say, minimum amount of thing that you need to process. So if you want to get good statistics, okay, you just use, for instance, a packet size of 1,500 bytes, and you will get here around hundreds of gigabits per second, okay? So it's a lot, okay? I have not done the multiplication, but you can multiply 48 times like 12,000, and you will get the amount of megabits per second. That's a lot. Okay, probably 600 gigabits per second, something like that. Okay, so it gives you a lot, more or less the impression of how quick is this. Okay, this is obviously possible because the VMs are, let's say, well designed. In this case, the software is well designed to exploit all the capabilities of the software, but it's also possible because the orchestrator and the VIM, okay, are able to deploy the VMs in the way that is designed by the VNF vendor itself to make the VNF work as expected. Okay. Well, and now the second scenario, I will show you just the the figure of the network service. So it was consisting of two network services, one with a BRAS and the other with a AAA network service. I think it might be relevant to show you here the network service so that you could get a good idea. So it was consisting mainly of a AAA radio server with a configuration server and also a load balancer. So the idea of this network service is that the VRAS could contact a single load balancer and the load balancer would distribute the load between the different AAA servers. And all things in the demo were expected to be configured by a configuration server that was also deployed. So this illustrates an example of a typical deployment that we are doing, for instance, also in our lab. It's at the BNF that is distributed jointly with an EMS, okay, so that it's also virtualized. So you deploy the BNF and the EMS, and from the EMS you can run configurations. And in this case, the EMS was prepared to, let's say, expose some actions via UUChamps. Okay? Well, it's a pity that I couldn't show you, but it's not working. But let me illustrate how the descriptors look like so that you understand the mapping that I was mentioning before. So, for instance, let's open the configuration server or the AAA, don't remember. Here. So, for instance, here you could see in the descriptor a section that is called BNF configuration. So this BNF configuration contains, let's say, all the mapping that is required to do the association to the CHAN. For instance, in this case, there is an initial config primitive that is called config, and let's say needs as parameters the SSH hostname, SSH username, and password. This is required to connect to the AAA. And then we have primitives like adduser that requires a user and domain and password. Okay. So I think, and the CHAN required for that is the AAA CHAN. That means that all these primitives at user and config needs to be part of that CHAN. So this is how the BNF descriptor is written to be able to expose those primitives later on in OSM. Okay. Well, sorry for the demo of the AAA. I couldn't show you, but I hope that you understand a little bit the concepts behind, okay, and how the descriptors. Let's say we use the descriptors to map the CHAN functionality to the primitives itself. Okay? Any question? Yes, that structure is specifically from OSM.
And will Etsy standardize that in the future, or is there a loop back into?
Can you rephrase? Or?
Yeah, I mean, you've defined a particular structure here that I guess OSM understands in terms of how the VNFD is structured.
Yeah.
This is not a standard thing. This is something that OSM has defined.
No, it's not a standard. It's the OSM information model itself. It's public. Let me show you here. I mean, it's part of the, it's all the information model and all the details are in our wiki. Hopefully it works the connectivity to OSM. Seems that it's not working now. I don't know why. Let me check. I am connected. All the, well, it's here. It's in the information model section, for instance, here. All information models are public here. You have a specific page that describes all the information model, and for each for the BNF descriptors, for the network service descriptors, you have here all the logic, and you could even navigate through an HTML page like this to see the content. For instance, here for the BNFD, you have all the information, you have the VDUs, the list of VDUs, you have the BNF configuration section that contains all the things that are here, okay? And this is, well, well known, it's public, and it's the model that we are promoting here. Yeah.
Okay, I guess my question really was, will this feed back into one of the SOL standards that Etsy is?
Yeah, that's clear. Yeah, 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 yeah. Yeah, yeah.
Okay, yeah. Thanks.
Yeah. We have already done that feedback for some of the parameters, but we will continue doing that, okay? Yeah, but for instance, that specific section related to configuration is something that we have and the standards are not taken into account at all for the moment. Mm-hmm. Any other question? Well, thank you. Thank you very much.